Hello guys, welcome to another video. Today we are going to do a video on Streamlabs OBS or SLOBS to be shortened, if it's shortened. Yeah, so anyway, this all guide will also be available, I mean applicable for OBS also. So those who are watching this stream, those who are watching this video, this is applicable for both SLOBS and OBS, so get ready. And we're gonna do some basics. Okay, this is today is only for basics. So get ready and enjoy the video. Let's begin. So all right, so everyone, this is the SLOBS, the window. As you can see, this is the full Streamlabs OBS version 0.95 which is up here, and we are in the editor mode where we can see the basically this is what you will see when you load the load this software up. I'm gonna bring my camera in, give me a second. Here we go. So anyway, you guys can see me in the bottom. Okay, so let's start with the basics. So dashboard and themes are both part of Streamlabs side. So we're not going to go with that because it's a completely different topic. So anyway, we have editor and live over here. Live is what you would see when you are when you go live. It will be something like this. It will take some time to load because you know it is actually loading a browser source over here in this area. So when you go live, there will be this screen. The events that happens, that is subscriber or donation events and all that. And live actions where you can do a lot of different stuff. This is all for another video, but let's go with the editor right now. So the first thing you'll see here is when you start, it will be a scenes here. This will not be there when you start up, and it'll be something called scene over here. Then what you can do is the sources is where you add your stuff. Like for example, is the video capture device. That's the camera that we are seeing using me right now, and of course display capture, which will be capturing the whole display, which is basically the whole screen of this thing. Also, you can do multiple different stuff like which are shown over here. I'll get to that in a second. Then we have mixer over here where you can actually add in your desktop audio and your mic audio. You can see here the mic audio is moving when I'm speaking to you guys. It will and there's another you can add multiple more audio sources which I'll show in the settings menu under the settings menu over here. Other things in scene menu, you can do like multiple scenes. For example, if I create a new scene, you can give it a new name like hello. Let's say put a new scene hello, and now you see that I can't see anything right now, it's black. Okay, give me a second. I can bring in something. You can see me full screen right now. So basically this adds, you can now switch between two screens. You can see right now, you can see my full face. You can see me in a small face. This is how scenes work. And to create a different stinger between the scenes, you can click over here. And basically you can, for now it's doing cut. Let's edit that and let's put fade. And click done. And now let's finish switch scenes. It fades and it fades out. So if you want to put your own custom scenes, there's something called Stinger over here. Stinger. This basically allows you to add a custom video file to put as a transition. I'll show you one of my scenes from my my stream right now. So let's get into the game before Razer breaks his tank. And that's how Stinger works. So basically that's how Stinger works. I'm not putting Stinger here right now. We'll put fade and just end it. I'll show you how to create a Stinger in a later video. So anyway, that's there. Then you can add sources here. You can basically add image source where you can add an image into your the stream. Color source, I have never checked that out. It's basically like adding a color, I guess. And then we have browser source where you can add web pages like chat box, anything you want, like browser source, you can add it there, but it should be a stationary that should be seen straight forward when you enter the browser URL. Media source, where you can run videos and other stuff. Image slideshow, where you can put multiple images together, it will keep on rotating. Text GDI, where you can put either text from which you want to type, text which you want to type, and text from text files, like .txt files, if you want to, like, that is basically, there's a much bigger use for that. I will tell you in another video. Display capture, we can capture the whole screen. Window capture, we can capture a specific window. Like, for example, if I open task manager. So for example, if I open, let's say calculator over here. Let's hope I open calculator right now. You guys can see it in here. You guys can see that. So I open calculator now. If I click on window capture, and if I click done, and then if I click calculator, it should show the calculator. I don't know why it's not showing, but basically this is the calculator app over here. It should come usually. Let's remove that. We can remove source from here. Next is game capture, where you can capture game full screen applications like game under this. Then we have a video capture device, which basically I use to capture my this thing. What do you call my face? You can also get video capture. You can use video capture device to capture from external sources like game capture cards and other stuff like that. If you have multiple cameras, you can do that also here. You can add a second camera, which I have right here. If you see my streams, I have a two camera setup, so I can add a second camera. I'll show you that also. The second video capture and video capture one, add source. Here I select my second cam, and then I just forgot to plug it in. Add, and here we go, second cam. You guys can see the second cam also. So basically I'm using the second cam. It's so bright. This is the second cam. First cam, you can do like that and add a new video source. That's how our video source is all about. Then next we have next we have audio input device. Here we can add a secondary input device from not just this mic over here. You can add an secondary input device into this, and we can capture via this one. Then audio output capture also is there, and then we have scene. We have can completely add a scene from the scenes over here into the sources. So basically, you can do that. Then we have widgets, which are available only to Streamlabs OBS. So basically, it's for adding chat box, donation ticker, etc., and all this stuff. That's only for SLOBS, but that's not like needed for OBS users. So I'm not doing that right now. I'll do that in a different video. So then we have mixer audio. What we can do here is basically set up desktop audio volume, mic audio volume, and all the volumes here, and we can set which track it should run on. And sync offset with the video. For example, if the video is not syncing with my voice, I can use that. I can sync that over here. So anyway, that's there. And now let's get into another mode, which is called studio mode, which is available both on OBS and Streamlabs OBS. What this does is, if you click on studio mode, this is the live mode, and this is the edited version. So for example, when I'm doing live right now, it will be showing the right side screen, and I can edit whatever I want in the left side screen, and then click on transition for it to transition to the live version. Also, you can click on the second scene, and I just click transition, it transitions to this other one. You can do it in either way. So this is basically useful if you have a second screen, not that much useful if you have a single screen, but you can do like editing on the go using this mode, studio mode. So let's see here. So below here you can see the CPU usage. It should be basically under 20 CPU usage, because if you are running a bigger game like PUBG or GTA, it'll be using much higher CPU. And if you keep it under 20, your game won't lag that much. If you are using a single PC to run this, run the game and the streaming together. Then we have the FPS. I don't know why it's running in 23 FPS right now, but basically it should run on 30 FPS, but we are running 22 FPS. I have no idea what is going on, but this is showing the output FPS from your stream or video you are recording, basically. Then we have drop frames. This is what will show how much frames is dropping. This will happen when you are live. So when you are live, frames will start. If your connection is unstable, the frames will start dropping and show you how much percentage of frames have dropped from the total stream over here. This will show you the bitrate of your video. Basically, if you set the bitrate of, okay. So bitrate is basically will show you the bitrate you set in your streaming tab. It will show you what is the bitrate at the present, because the bitrate won't be same. It will fluctuate up and down depending on your internet speed. Then we have here is what notifications. It will show you the notifications of any or all changes that happen in the stream. Then we have test widgets, which is only available to Streamlabs OBS. Let's go into the settings now. The first will show you basically like language and all this alignment snap. This is used to basically snap the scenes into place. Without that, it will be harder to like snap to the edge. You might overrun it a little bit. It's just a will help you do it faster, snapping. So if you tick it all of this and basically if you put in the same settings as I'm using, it'll be easy for you. Then we have stream. Stream is where you set your streaming service. For example, if you go to here, you see it custom and streaming server. If you select custom server, you have to select what server you're going the URL. I'll show you. If you click here, you have to set the URL of this custom server and the stream key, which is available from your streaming platform. You just need to get the stream key, copy and paste it here, and don't show the stream key to anyone, because anyone can access your channel. So you can do that, or you can select here, like for example Twitch, YouTube Gaming, Smashcast, Mixer, anything is there. You can select, and if you click show all services, it'll show you every service available that is supported by OB or Streamlabs service, depending on which version you're running. Then we have if you are using Twitch, you can select a server, for example like Singapore, this and that, like near server. We'll do that later if you are going for the Twitch. Then we have output, where we can set, wait, let's minimize everything first, then we'll continue with this tutorial. Oop. Minimize, okay, let's go. So once when you load it, it'll be simple. Switch to advanced to get advanced options, because advanced options, you'll be able to set as like intricate details of all settings you want to set. Alright, so if first let's go into streaming. Streaming uses, let's say set it to audio track 1. Then we have this one, this option, this is encoder option. It either uses software on NVENC. Software options uses CPU usage. It is a CPU, all your scenes will be rendered on a CPU. And if you select NVENC, all your scenes will be rendered in your GPU, that is NVIDIA GPU. NVENC means only for NVIDIA, NVIDIA encoder or something like that. Then you don't need to select this, and never select this here, because this will put more pressure on your CPU or GPU, whatever you selected over here. So don't select it here. Let it be like that. Then we have rate control. You should set it to CBR because if you have a good network, you should set it to CBR. CBR means constant bitrate. And then there is VBR, in case you have like a very unstable net, you use VBR, which is variable bitrate. I don't know what CQP is, but lossless will give you like a full HD quality without any loss. So if you set lossless, unless you have a really good network, don't never select lossless, especially on streaming. Okay. Oop, no resale output. Okay. So next is bitrate. Bitrate is something which is debated all over the internet. Everyone wants to know what bitrate it is, very good for which resolution. But I will put up will come over on the screen right now what is the best bitrate for every resolution for YouTube and Twitch. I'm gonna make my own set for them, and that is the ideal bitrate for streaming on Twitch and YouTube. But now we are going into the deep part. Okay, so the best way to set your bitrate is your bitrate is 80% of your upload speed. For example, if your upload speed of 10 Mbps, 10 into 80 by 100 will give you the bitrate you can set. That will be a maximum bitrate you can set. So even if you are if you want to stream in 1080p, if your maximum bitrate calculated doesn't go to that bitrate, don't stream in 1080p, go to 720p, or if it's not 720p, go to 480p, because your net is the one that is deciding the bitrate factor. Okay, so this is a bitrate I'm using for 1080p. and so drop whatever your upload speed is into the equation. It will be popping up on screen. X will be dropping under X. Whatever your bitrate is, drop it under X into 18 by 100. Will give you the bitrate. You have to type it in here. Then using that, go back to the previous one and select which resolution you have to, you can stream on. Then next we have to select, let's finish the bitrate stuff there. And then we'll go to keyframe interval. Keyframe interval is where you have to select, it's basically 2 for every, like Twitch and YouTube both are telling us to put 2 as keyframe interval. So I guess, yeah, you should put 2 as keyframe interval as a default. Then we have preset. I'm using Blu-ray, but you can use high quality or high performance depending on your processor performance. High performance would be the best option if you are using a little bit older CPU or GPU. If you have a good GPU like mine, you can go for Blu-ray. Or else you can, if you have a medium here and there a GPU or CPU, you can go for high quality. Then we have profile, you set it to high and main. There's no difference between high and main. I don't know why it's there. Then level, you set it to 4.2. This is only for GPU settings, okay, 4.2. And if your GPU is powerful enough, use 2-pass encoding. And this GPU setting 0 or and 2 for 0 GPU will set it to your first GPU. That is, if you have only one GPU, set it to 0. If you have two GPUs, you can set it to 1 if you have a second GPU. Then B frames will, I have no idea what B frames mean, but B frames is set to 2 in all YouTube and Twitch. So that's what is basically settings for NVENC, and CPU will be basically almost same. Here I will tell you about CPU right now. CPU, you can set it to CBR, and 5000 is my, you know, buffer size, and custom buffer size also 5000. This bitrate also is set by the same equation which I said in the previous one also. Use the same equation and find your bitrate. Okay, I completely lost the wording there. Then you set this to 2, and here is the major thing. Now first what you have to do is, it will be always in very fast. If you go up, it will use less CPU. If you go down, it will use more CPU. So you have to be really careful on how you set. If you have a Ryzen processor or a 6 core processor or above 6 cores, you can slowly go downwards and select which one you want. But don't go to, like, suddenly go into placebo. It'll kill your CPU. It'll have very bad negative effects on your CPU and your stream and on your game. So don't go to placebo immediately. Work one by one. See which one you can set. And then you set your CPU usage. And that'll be your CPU usage forever. Set this to high. And never use tune. There's no use there. X64 options is only for very, 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 very advanced users. So don't use it here at all. I use NVIDIA because my NVIDIA is good. So this is my settings. So that's the settings for streaming. Let's go into recording. Recording is only if you want to record. I'm not going to run through recording that much. But in recording, you can increase your bitrate to how much you want. But don't go into like 50,000 bitrate. If you want to put a 1080p video on YouTube, 12,000 will be the best bitrate. You can set, you can use the settings as same as from the streaming section in here to get the same quality. I mean, same same performance, and you can increase the bitrate to get more better quality. That's it. That's all. There's a difference between streaming and recording. Then audio track, or you can set it to 128 if your net is not that powerful. And you can set it to 320 to get the the best audio quality possible by this thing. If you go above 320, there's nothing much major changes. You can set it to 320. That's all for streaming, recording, and audio track over here. Let's go into audio. In audio, you can set your default audio device and your mic auxiliary device. This is where you set up your audio settings. Like, for example, here you can set your Discord audio, your game audio, your mic audio, your second mic audio. If you have a secondary mic or something like that, you can add that. If you are doing a podcast, you can do multiple microphones in this. You can add it here in this setting over here. In video, you can set your base canvas. Base canvas resolution is a resolution of a screen. For me, it's 1080p. That's why it's there. And I can output it into whatever resolution I want. For where I told about the bitrate in the before section. You can set, for example, if you have a lesser bitrate, and you can set your resolution here. Never set resolution in the output settings. Set it over here. And then if you're setting, if the bitrate is, I mean, the output resolution is lesser than your base resolution, go to LANSOX sharpened scaling. Or if it's the same as your base resolution, select bilinear, because that will decrease. This is basically for sharpening. Like sometimes it becomes blurry when you downscale it. So for sharpening, you can use LANSOX or bicubic, depending on how your CPU performs. Then FPS type, you select common FPS values, and you can select the FPS values depending on how your bitrate is. So never go for, if you are going for 6000 bitrate 1080p 60, that'll work. But if you are lesser than 6000 bitrate, don't go for 60 FPS, go for 30 FPS 1080p. So you can select it using the same chart I posted. Then hotkeys, you can set your hotkeys, like for example, if you are having a Stream Deck or a separate foot pedal or something like that, you can set it to switch or stinger or do whatever you want. You can set it here. For example, if I want, I can set it like 9, and if I click 9, it will show video capture device or remove it. Let's say I'll show you one thing. Switch to scene, hello. Let's put us 9. Okay, let's click done. Now if I click 9 on my keyboard, it switched to the hello screen. That is the scene switches. Let's go back, and that's basically how to put in hotkeys. You can put in whatever hotkeys you want in this for any setting. For muting, for unmuting, it's your choice. If you have a good Stream Deck, or if you have a separate keyboard or separate shortcuts for this, you can put it here. Macro keys also are useful here. So advanced. Here advanced is where you set up like stuff like process priority, color format, monitoring, and stream delay. So let's go to general. You set it to normal or below normal if you are using on the same PC, like streaming and the game on the same PC, put it below normal. If you have okay and good CPU and GPU, put it on normal. If you are using two different PCs to stream and game, put it high. I don't mind, just put it high. Then video, you have to select NV12, that is the NVIDIA's color palette, which NVIDIA uses to, you know, show you the game. Then you use 709 and partial as your YUV, color space and color range. This will give you the maximum color quality in your stream, color quality. Then you set default and disable video audio deck, Windows audio decking to remove something called audio decking, which I'll put in a different video because that'll be useful thing for streamers. I'll tell you in a different video. In stream delay, enable and put in 0 to get minimum stream delay, and don't tick this. If you tick this, there'll be a delay when you each time it network dips. When a network dips, suddenly this will increase your delay. So if you switch it off, it will decrease your delay. But at the point where your network drops, there will be small like stuttering in your video. But your delay won't be increased. That's your choice. If you want your delay to increase without that stuttering to come, you can tick it. If you want the delay to not increase and stuttering to come, you have to untick it. Then we have scene collections, where basically you can export and import everything, overlay and all the stuff. That's only for Streamlabs OBS. The notifications, appearance, it's not. These are all not available in your usual OBS. It's not available. And remote controls also not available in OBS. But in Streamlabs OBS, it's a handy feature. I'll show you how this works. So basically, as you can see here, it shows a QR code. If I click to show QR code, and if the PC and the phone are in the same, you know, same network, you can actually go here. If you click on, I'll show you. If you come to your Streamlabs OBS app in your phone, it will show this thing. You guys can see here. Yeah, you guys can see here. So this is basically will show you to scan the QR code to get to access remote. If I scan this QR code here right now, I'm scanning it. Give me a second. Scanning. Doing that. So anyway, it's connected. Mouse, yeah. So if you guys can see here, you can see the phone screen right now is showing all the things inside. So if I click on, let's say, hello over here, it will switch the screen into other things. So basically, you can use a Streamlabs OBS remote to control your full Streamlabs stream. So basically, this is how you use that to control this. So that's all the settings, and that's all you can know. So scenes, sources, settings, mixer, everything. This is basically all the basics which I told. So if you want any more videos on these topics, any topics, like if you want audio ducking, how to create scenes, different scenes, sting, how to create stinger, how there are multiple things we can basically go through this. There are a lot more avenues to cover on this on further videos. So if you want something, if you want to ask about something specific, please put in the comment below and hit the like button so that I know that you like the video, you got informed of some stuff on how to create your OBS streams and how to start off your OBS. Hopefully this video was informative for you guys. So thank you all for watching, guys. If you like this video, please hit the like button, subscribe, hit that notification icon, because there'll be more videos coming soon. Thank you all for watching, guys, and hope to see you all soon. Peace out.